keeping them honest every night. AC360. CNN, weeknights 10 Eastern.
3 weeks after the devastating earthquake and tsunami, a dramatic rescue, a tale of survival. Japan's Coast Guard rescues a dog found floating on debris off Kesanuma. A small boat was sent out and a rescuer jumped into the sea and carried the dog to safety. She was skittish at first, but after eating some sausage and cookies, started wagging her tail and licking rescuers' faces. Her three-week ordeal finally over, her spirit restored with a little food and a lot of affection. The dog's name is Ban. It turns out her owner saw footage of her on TV in a temporary relocation center in Sendai, and this family member went to pick her up. Unfortunately, reunions probably won't happen for many dogs, especially those left behind in the evacuation zone near the damaged Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant. This video was shot by a freelance journalist 2 weeks after the tsunami. The journalists risked their lives entering the mandatory evacuation zone, exposing themselves to dangerous radiation levels. What they found was heartbreaking. Dogs still in their homes, still waiting in vain for their owners to return. One dog chained up, left behind, starving, his ribs visible. One of the journalists gave this starving dog his lunch. And this photo captures the desperate situation. A dog obviously left behind, likely tied up, who chewed its way through his leash. Food is in short supply, and there are no organizations that will come to rescue them. For them, hope is virtually non-existent. Kyung Lah joins us now live from Tokyo. Kyung, there were a lot of interest in the dogs, obviously, we showed. That in particular, the dog who was found tethered to a pole. People are asking whether or not the man who shot the video actually untied the dog. Do you know?
He did not. And he says that, and we just spoke with him a short time ago, the journalist says that he wanted to. It was a very tough decision, but he felt in his gut that somehow that owner was going to violate the government order and sneak back in and get that dog. That the dog, he made sure had enough water, and he did give him his lunch, and he did not want to remove the dog from the premises just in case the owner came back. There is something culturally at play here, Anderson. Japanese don't typically like to infringe on other people's property. So that certainly was also a factor.
And we should point out this is not a CNN personnel, so that's why you're talking about somebody else who you got in contact with. Can these dogs be taken out? I mean, if radiation levels within the evacuation zone are very high, is it safe to remove them? Probably not.
It is. There are people who were there as well. Once those animals come out, they simply have to be checked for radiation. The big hurdle here is actually getting those animals out. Remember, this is a mandatory evacuation zone. No one is allowed in, and that's the challenge here.
So are there any groups that are going in to try to help them?
Break this up into parts. Outside the evacuation zone, outside the zone right around the nuclear plant, there is a lot of activity as far as trying to connect dogs and cats with their owners. There's an entire tsunami area. We've spoken to the Japan Earthquake Animal Rescue and Support Group. They're a no-kill group, and they're trying to reconnect animals and owners outside the zone. Those are dogs that are outside the zone. Inside the zone, there are independent animal lovers that CNN has spoken with. These are people who are not working officially with any organization. They're sneaking in, they're violating the order, and they're going in and rescuing the dogs. The people I spoke with say they want to make this absolutely clear. They're making sure these are owners who have specifically asked for their dogs to be removed from the premises, that they're not touching any of their animals, but they are leaving water and food for any animals they see. What they describe is that it's simply heartbreaking. There's so many animals who are still in that zone. It wouldn't take that long to evacuate everybody. The government just needs to go in and get those animals.
The other question is, are there shelters that allow animals in them? Because, you know, people have evacuated. They're not in their homes, not just the ones who are in the evacuation zone, but in destroyed areas. Are there shelters that allow animals?
Yes, there are. You'd be really surprised. You can see that people have their dogs and cats in the shelters living with them. The Japanese love animals, especially dogs. And so the owners who did leave with their dogs are able to keep them. Sometimes in some of these shelters, especially in the really hard-hit areas, there's a specific space where you keep your animal, but it is possible. The hard part for that nuclear evacuation area is that they didn't know how long they were going to be gone. They thought maybe a few days, maybe a week. But now they may never go back.
Right. We certainly saw this in Hurricane Katrina, and frankly, we've seen it in all the disasters that we've covered. Kyung Lah, I appreciate the update. Thank you very much.